you can even hear mom's laugh. Mom's laughter is a cry for help. Yeah, like she's on the verge of crying. Oh, I look like the Joker.
Hey everyone, support our Patreon, which helps us to continue bringing you our live streams, videos, and podcasts while bringing you new content such as exclusive live streams and animated shorts.
We've been doing these movies that have been suggested by the millennials out there. Such, we have one right here, such a creature right here. Mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. a lot of you millennials out there, and even some late Gen Z people, and y'all remember how you used to watch these Disney Channel original movies.
That's right.
It was such a great part of your childhood. You grew up with such fun memories of them until you became adults and like, man, this is bullshit. Hell, what did I ever remember about this?
It's often the case. Great. It's often the case, yeah.
This scared the hell out of me. We watched one like a couple of weeks ago.
Well, which one was? Don't look under the bed. Come on.
Don't look under the bed. Yeah.
Not with Larry Houdini.
Larry Houdini was all I could remember from that.
Yeah. Don't look under the bed. That might be a shitty movie.
there definitely is.
Yeah.
Not might.
Yeah. So I thought y'all was doing this man over here. I was bringing back a chunk of his childhood. And I was going to educate him again and say, you know, your childhood is not what you thought. It was a lie.
Oh, shit.
All those wonderful specials and movies you saw, no, they weren't as great. Mm-hmm. And I was going to pull one over here that a lot of people been saying, hey, man, the next one that you got to do, the next one you got to talk about, please, Halloween is near. Talk about your boy, Mr. Boogedy over there.
I don't know what that shit is.
That came out in 86. He's like, Mr. Boogedy was before my time.
Yeah, it is. There's no millennial stuff. I can tell you that right now.
Well,
yeah. So if it's not for millennials, who's been suggesting this?
I don't know.
Weird people.
A lot of people have been recommending Mr. Boogedy out there. I don't know. Maybe they caught it in reruns. And somehow, maybe they played it on the Disney Channel during the times when Halloween was coming around.
Not when I was growing up. I don't remember Mr. Boogedy.
I don't know. I think it was like an hour-long special with commercials that came on ABC back in 1986. Dealt with, as always, a haunted house that, I'm not going to get into it, but I would just say that these white people had so many chances to leave. They were told that there was a Mr. Boogedy there.
Yeah,
and
I know.
And they did not. They did not leave. Even when they told them that Mr. Boogedy, he scared everybody else from this house. Y'all, I don't know what y'all think, and that you're so special that he's not gonna get you too.
A Disney Sunday movie.
Dad, let's go home.
Okay, so you don't want to talk. Fine.
But beware of Mr. Boogedy. Sunday.
Sunday.
So dry.
Yeah.
Sunday.
I guess. I'm sorry. It's not like a gay narrator. Sunday. And bring your jukebox money. Mr. Boogedy.
It needed some of that. I didn't hear none of that right there.
No. Even the narrator don't give a shit. Sunday. Shit, yeah.
Well, I guess they cut it and sent it out. And it's like, we haven't told anybody when this is happening.
Yeah. Hey, y'all are right. Somebody even wrote down a little joke, a little observation I knew. They said, why does he look like a green ass Palpatine? Oh,
he totally does.
But if you were here to see Mr. Boogedy himself, then you would be sorely disappointed. I would even tell you, Mr. Boogedy, the guy that the movie's named after, is probably in the movie for about 3 minutes. Now, what you do get in this, you get this dumbass family right here. Mm-hmm. Who I say dumbass family. I gotta make an exception here, except the daughter, Jennifer, played by Christy Swanson.
Buffy which is the Vampire Slayer.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, Buffy the Vampire Slayer. So you know, you've seen her. So she's not a terrible actress, but in this she is. She out of this whole family. She's probably the worst one.
Damn.
Really?
Yeah.
You think she's the worst?
I thought she was absolutely horrible in this.
I saw him!
Who?
The Boogedy Man! His face, it was all yucky and like a grilled cheese sandwich or something.
Okay, wait a minute.
Grilled cheese sandwich.
Yeah. So for somebody who's that bad, you must feel really sorry for her to give her a pass. Yeah. And I do.
Well, I thought that the mom, played by Mimi Kennedy, who's and also an accomplished actress who's been in tons of stuff, in the first half, I thought she was the worst. I was like, wow, she does not care about being here at all.
Don't nobody really give a about it. They all, the adults here, they're like, I'm in Mr. Boogedy. You know, I don't give a
Man, the thing is, you could be the most talented actor in the world, but if you get shit direction, a shit script, you're going to give a bad performance, a really bad performance. Yeah. So that's just seems to be the case here.
I'll tell you the reason why I give her a pass is because you have to see what she's dealing with.
Oh, yeah.
You know, you you think living with your dad and all these dad jokes is, you know, that they're bad? No.
You don't even know.
No. Your dad ain't got nothing on this motherfucker. This movie, the dad in this movie, who's the guy?
Richard Masur,
who's
a TV actor mostly, been in a lot of stuff. He usually either plays a goofy guy or a serial killer.
Yeah, well,
so
he's kind of both right here. So this man right here, your dad ain't got nothing on the dad in this. He is a dad joke.
That's how he makes his money.
That's how he makes his money. He's a walking dad joke. First moment we see him, got jokes.
I don't see why we have to move to the middle of nowhere with a bunch of farmers and cows and no cute boys.
Life with this guy. You know, this is what y'all got to live with.
I mean, look, Disney dads are always goofy and out of touch.
Weird.
And they're the dumbest people in the family. But this guy's at a different level.
he really is. I mean, this it's because, look, again, you know, your dad might have jokes, but you know, the thing is, your dad will tell you a joke, and then he'll even tell you, like, ain't that funny? Get the fuck away from me. You know, All right, go on, take a little ass on somewhere. But he'll tell you the joke, he'll be done with it, and both y'all can go about y'all's day.
Right, you don't even see him the rest of the day.
Yeah, you don't even see him the rest of the day. Not only does this fool keep going, man, but he got props. It's like living with a prop comic. It's like living with it's like living with Carrot Top, except not as funny.
Oh, damn. Oh,
if you can believe that. It's like living with Gallagher and Carrot Top and all these motherfuckers, man. It's like, you know, and the thing is, he owns a gag shop. That's the reason why. Mm. And the gag shop may close, but this fool is open.
Why.
He is open 24/7, man. He don't stop.
He's their number one product.
This man never closes.
Right.
You can't eat breakfast without this dude around.
Gee, I thought these were different. They look pretty good to me. What do you think?
Jesus, this asshole.
That was a secondary joke about those eggs.
Yeah, he had bacon and ham. Flapjacks.
Oh, wow. I love it. Hey, eat your eggs. Oh, these eggs are rubber. Oh, yeah, look close. Squirt.
Yeah.
God damn it, man.
I mean, this kid is like every morning, man.
I'm he so likes hungry.
Every morning.
He seems to be into it.
I haven't had a real meal in 4 years.
Yes, you were surprised that this family ever gets to eat.
Yeah, I talk about how bad the mom was, but part of me started thinking, like, she's just tired.
You know, I'm surprised that this family can ever fix a meal. Cause nobody can get anything done around this man.
Gag City.
Just get the divorce. You know you want it. You got the lawyer's number right over there. Just call.
She's having an affair. That's the only way she stays sane.
She has
getting
to.
Yeah.
Has to. People, the reason why, and you're going to keep hearing about this because the horror in this this children's horror show, our special, is not Mr. Boogedy, it's Dad.
Yeah.
Dad is the real villain here. Dad's the horror. He's pranked this family so much, he's kind of got them Stockholm now.
Yeah.
Stockholm syndrome is set in, man.
So much that they don't mind a poltergeist.
they don't care.
Not as bad as Dad.
got these poor kids just as crazy. Mm-hmm. like they're little kids, man. You know, they just doing what dad has taught them, man.
Taught them, right.
These kids don't know any better. And these kids are just as nuts as he is.
Eat the eggs!
He You're like, Jesus, what have I done?
Jesus Christ. That's weird.
Hey, son, sorry. Don't step on my punchline. Because I'll beat your ass in front of everybody.
He's like, I'm done wrong. I'm so sorry, kid. I'm so sorry. You know, this poor kid, man. Like, everyone at school is going to hate this kid.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's going to be f***ing everybody.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to be the kid that the teachers pay bullies to beat up.
Oh, they'll just ignore when he's getting beat up.
Just turn around. They just adjusting the glass and not looking.
All right, you kids, stop horsing around over there.
Yeah. Mom has been Stockholmed. She was tired of that shit at first, but now she's just, everything he does, she just snorting.
Jesus.
Oh, God. Don't you love it?
Yeah, you know he's choked her several times. Don't you love it? Huh?
She's crazy too. It's a Pavlov response.
That's brilliant.
Yes, that honey, laugh is
the pranks are funny if you just get that stick out of your ass and go with it. Okay? I don't have to tell you this again.
You can even hear mom's laugh. Mom's laughter is a cry for help. Yeah, like she's on the verge of crying. Oh, look like the Joker. Just got this family Stockholm, man. All of them. That's the moment they just didn't have any laughs. Just like, okay, Dad, yeah, fine, thank you. There are moments where they really are completely just sick of his shit.
Right?
Yeah.
They are plotting this man's death. These kids are going to kill these parents.
That dead-eyed expression.
Yeah, that right dead-eyed there. Expression right there. They are plotting to kill this man. And when these fools have their own Netflix documentary crime special, they're going to tell them, too. Why did you kill your parents? They just wouldn't stop pranking and pranking.
Check the footage.
Pranking. It was the only way to end it, was to destroy them. These that dad is the villain here, man. And you soon realize dad is mentally ill.
Oh, yeah.
And he's like, this is a condition with him. He's not right, man. These jokes are an addiction. Jenny, the daughter, you know, Mr. Boogedy got a hold of her and knocked the ass out or drugged her, cosmed her, or some shit. Now, I don't know what he did to her before he left, but before he did leave, for some reason, this is just Boogedy logic right here. Before he left, he just stamped footprint stickers all on the wall right there. Why? I don't know. I ain't trying to make some cheap race joke or nothing. I'm just telling you how it is. This man is so silly with this whole situation, this Mr. Boogedy situation. That is why he is the most stereotypical white person I've ever seen. Okay. With a haunted house.
Fair enough.
That is your stereotype.
I'll allow it.
You know, that's white people's stereotype right there.
Haunted house.
No,
it's happened so much at this point, we've all become numb to it.
Oh, yeah.
Of course. That, white people, stop doing that.
It ain't, but that's the thing, man. Right when you think you've seen it, you've never seen it.
He ups it.
He does, man.
Okay, all right. He doubles down.
I don't know how much he paid for this piece of shit house right here, but.
No, you haven't seen it.
I don't know how much he paid for this piece of shit house right here, but he ain't leaving. He ain't budging, man. It's almost like he wants to live in a haunted house, but deny that there's ghosts there.
Be a good prank, right?
The ultimate prank. I don't know where that noise came from.
Do they set up a reason at least? Is like, well, we can't afford any other place, and we were putting money down for it. So there's no reason why the
it was
there.
Just he's cheap.
He's okay. Cheap.
And okay. he bought a fixer upper.
Okay.
And the thing is that like I said, he's just a creepy.
He's just weird. He's just unnaturally weird.
Like he moves in at night while there's a thunderstorm going on.
Do you think it's haunted, Dad?
course not. Isn't it great?
Isn't it great?
Did you see her expression change?
Yeah. When he touched her.
She's like, oh.
Yeah, she, y'all didn't see the pictures? Yeah, she came out like, ah, oh, goddamn. What the f***?
That smile just dissolved.
Yeah. Isn't it great?
Doing that donkey of her laugh of hers.
When people get there, all of them a little concerned, even the kids. They're like, yeah, I don't know what the hell you were thinking. What's he doing? You know, everyone's scared except him. He still got jokes.
Whoa, wrong flashlight.
You know, that's when the ghost would have packed up and just said, you know what, y'all got this. Yeah. Will, this is going to be too much of a challenge to like, try to get y'all out this shit. No. Because if we kill you, then we're going to be stuck with your ass.
Exactly.
Yeah, y'all have this shit. We're gone, man. Good luck. Okay, kids, good luck with all that. Boo.
No, come back.
They were told so many times. That's what I'm saying. The house already had the atmosphere. And then when they get there, there's a fool in the dark. Gomez Adams.
Right.
Gomez Adams is waiting for them. The Gomez Adams from the Adams family is there in the dark to tell them, get the f*** out.
How do you do, Mr. Davis?
Man, when Gomez Adams is telling your ass to leave, he's creepy and he's spooky. You know, that then it's time to go. It is time to go. And whenever there's anybody waiting in your living room in the dark to tell you to leave.
Exactly. The idea of like, wait, they sold me this place and didn't change the locks. And how long have you been sitting here waiting for us to show up?
Shit, the ghost, the townspeople are crazy as hell. Got Mandrake the magician waiting for you in the house. Before you get in there, you gotta get the hell out of that house, man. I'm looking at all the creepy shit they got here. You know, the townspeople breaking in, sitting in your house in the middle of the dark, getting creepy with your daughter.
I have a son your age. He's unusual.
If you don't get the away from me. You don't get your ass away from me up in the dark. I didn't ask you about your son. Especially if he's crazy as you are.
Yeah. He's unusual.
He's like, yeah, like you, bitch. So if this fool is the one telling you to get out, then you probably want to leave.
I'd like to welcome you to our town and warn you, get out.
What?
That's a mixed messages.
That logic makes no sense whatsoever.
That's why you need to leave.
Okay.
Before Mr. Boogedy or any kind of spirit or ghost shows up, this fool is a warning. The moment you see them crazy eyes and that goddamn beaver ass mustache, get the hell out.
It was a goddamn scheme of his. He makes the money, then he's like, all right, now get the he gets the next fucking group of people in there. It's like, they didn't leave the first time. Jeez, we up our game. Mr. Boogedy, you come on in.
Gomez Adams, the town crazy man, the serial killer in here. You know, if he come in here and tell you to leave, leave. Nah, Dad sees that shit. That's another opportunity to show you one of my other gags.
Neil Witherspoon.
Joy buzzers. Pretty great, huh?
You like...
Yeah, wait, what are you, 6 years old?
Yeah.
I just met you.
Yeah.
And you just reset my pacemaker, you asshole. My heart just stopped.
Hey, he's killing his ass right now. He's having a heart attack. He's like this childish motherfucker. He's like, really?
All right.
He's like, boy,
that's how it's going to be, huh?
Okay, this is going to be harder than I thought it was going to be. Shit, this ain't worth it. There's a moment here. I mean, when the shit starts to really go down, you know, they still there. And they got proof that things are bad. When they know it's a haunted house, they still sticking around. Don't ask, but somehow they ended up with a mummy on PCP or something.
Rubber hands.
Dad's like, cool. Shit, that mummy had some moves, didn't he? Dad didn't give a f-. Dad like, okay, y'all see that shit? That's kind of awesome, man.
I mean, he's no Pennywise, but he puts on a nice little dance there.
Hey, I bet none of the other neighbors have a mummy in their house with some smooth moves like that.
Little interpretive dance. Collapsing down to a pose.
There's a dude just suffocating. Help me. Help me.
He's trying to get the wrappings off himself.
Help me. Yeah, man. Mom with her silly ass. Kind of bad too, man. She sees a ghost right there. And what does she do? Again, that's what I'm saying. It's that white stereotype you should be mad about. Mm. She does some white haunted house shit. She doesn't run. She doesn't, you know, call the kids. Like, she's like, oh, are you a ghost? Oh, you must come in for coffee.
Your widow, Marianne.
Yes. Oh, well, this is a pleasure because the children told us all about you. You must come in. You must.
Yeah, she told her too, like, no, Boogedy. Mr. Boogedy's coming. Oh, well, we'll invite him in too. Come on in.
More than Mary.
It's cold out there. Come in.
She's been day drinking. That's what it is.
Yeah,
that's what they all have a much darker problem, you know, in hand. Dad's in with some trauma. That's why he constantly has to overperform the jokes. Mom, tolerate her husband and her kids. Does day drink. She's like, I don't give a shit anymore.
Yeah, this shit ain't
come
even real.
Or yeah.
Laudanum or Oxycontin.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Yeah. Pill popping, definitely. Yeah. See, you could do a remake of this, but it'd be much darker.
Yeah.
Although, you know, everybody else freaks out when they see the ghost and they end up dying. Mm. Her befriending the ghost, I was like, it's a different take.
It is, sure.
It's kind of working out.
That's how much mom is getting sick of dad, that she's inviting the ghost in. I need friends, please. At this point, you just like, man, where's Mr. Boogedy?
Maybe he could talk some sense,
scare some sense in these people, you know. Maybe he's the one that's finally gonna scare them straight, you know, because everything else ain't working. And you're looking forward to seeing Mr. Boogedy because he's got kind of a weird backstory, a little wild.
His backstory, I am not kidding. It plays out like a high school play.
Oh damn!
And not even from running like the prominent high schools.
Oh no, we like an elementary school play. Yeah, they do the backstory, and they ain't got no money to they ain't got no money to go into colonial times.
Yeah,
they ain't got
money. But we're talking about cardboard sets.
That's what they have money for. That's what they have.
Right. I don't know why I said high school. This is elementary.
Elementary school, man. Damn. They had some 11-year-olds make this set. They didn't have no money. They couldn't go on location to shoot this. So for Mr. Boogedy's backstory, they drew all that out. Mm-hmm. Trying to make it artistic and interpretive. Uh-huh. Nah, man. People be having a good time, kids having fun, and all he just come out yelling Boogedy, 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 get your ass out of Boogedy, Boogedy.
Yeah.
Oh, the children called him Mr. Boogedy because he delighted in scaring them. Boogedy!
Ain't nobody even there.
Yeah, I know.
Wow.
And the thing is that this man, he's all, and then he does this shit to these kids and to everybody, getting in front of their face talking about Boogedy, and then he's wondering, man, how come people don't like me?
Right?
Because they're tired of your ass yelling Boogedy at them all day long. And since nobody likes him, he's one of those, like, you're right, he's a grouch. Mm-hmm. He's almost like one of the first incels. He's like, you know, because he's going around town yelling Boogedy in front of everybody's face, scaring kids and whatnot, and then he's gonna blame everybody else when women don't want to get with his stupid ass. You know, he can't figure out, well, how come women don't like me? Maybe because you f***ing Boogedy all day and scaring people and going to take it out on everybody else. Hmm. Like, there's one chick that he's into. One woman that he's really trying hard to get that ass, boy. And
way too young for him.
Way too young for him, and she even knows it. And she kind of quietly, politely makes fun of him. Oh, son, does he tryeth? Tell him he has no chanceth. And the kid even is like, yeah, you ain't getting shit. And that's when Mr. Boogedy is like, all right, you know what? I'm gonna fix your little cock blocking ass.
I am sure that he tryeth.
I don't think so, mother.
Make fun of me.
Yeah, I got something for your ass. You better just turn your back on me.
You're right. He's the first incel.
The first incel, man. Blame that kid. Not your crazy ass, you little cock blocking son of a bitch.
If it wasn't for you, I'd be all up in that.
Yeah. Get your ass out of here. He just goes and makes he calls up Satan. He just makes a deal.
Oh my god.
Or a dude dressed like Satan. Jesus.
This is embarrassing.
I know, you're like, is this even the actual Satan?
Yeah, is this
he made a deal with Larry.
Yeah, he just calls him, dude up. You're like, hey, is this Satan? Yeah, I'm Satan. Yeah, that's me, what you need.
Wow.
He makes this deal with Satan, man. To makes a deal with Satan to get a magic cloak. Doesn't really make much sense, but it helps him with his nefarious schemes.
He sold his soul to the devil that night. Sold his soul for a magic cloak. It might even give him the widow.
Boy, Satan about to bend that ass over. You see what he's feeling on his shoulder? Oh, yeah.
You're curvy. You're one of the curvy ones, aren't you?
Yeah. Yes. Hey, what are you doing? Hey, part of the deal.
This is how I extract the soul. Once I'm done, you'll feel like a piece of you is missing.
By the way, his story is so silly that they tell it. So check this out. So they don't even give this stupid ass story the dignity of being in a real history book. That shit is in a pop up book.
A small group of pilgrims live on this very spot.
It's like, wow. That's history. You couldn't even.
I know. That's the reveal, huh?
You notice how it's not even a professional illustrator who did that?
No, it's the same kids that did that. So, no, that's what I was going to tell you. Yeah, that's his whole plan was to kidnap the. So, since he couldn't get with the woman, he said, well, you know what? Since I got this invisible cloak, I'm going to kidnap your son. I'm going to bring him to my house. I'm going to lure your ass over there.
Jesus.
And when he gets him there.
He blew up his own house.
He blew up his own house?
That's what I said. Jesus.
What a dope.
What a dope.
Was not in the script. That kid heard that story the first time. You're like, that's stupid.
That's great.
So he blew up, not set on fire, blew up the house. How? I don't know. They don't go. That was some shit that was just.
Felt like it was improv on the spot.
Oh yeah, it was just suddenly tacked on.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. Yeah, that makes no sense at all, man. So when Mr. Boogedy does at some point finally show up, it's no surprise after hearing his backstory. It's no surprise he's stupid too. You know, it's all he does is show up and just like we said, you know, like Emperor Palpatine style, just shoot electricity from his fingers and keep yelling Boogedy, which of course doesn't mean shit to the dad.
Boogedy! Boogedy!
Okay, so you don't want to talk, fine. But this is our house.
You know, Mr. Boogedy's like, God, this motherfucker.
This dude's gone. But I said Boogedy, though.
Yeah. I'm about to get a stick and shove it up to the man. Like, this boy, he really listens to me. God damn it.
Hey, the man is dedicated to his homestead.
He ain't going nowhere. Even when he's getting electrocuted by a goddamn ghost. Like, look, all right, well, let's talk this over now because we're not going anywhere. It's funny. You know, he can't do nothing. No one can do anything with his dad. So Mr. Boogedy, he just says, if y'all ain't gonna leave, I'm just gonna fuck with your kids. He just starts chasing one of the kids around with a vacuum cleaner.
Oh no! Help
somebody! Yeah, exactly. Shit, I'm gonna get one of you motherfuckers.
I'm not leaving it handed.
If dad ain't gonna listen, I'll take this little motherfucker right now. It's funny because that's the vacuum cleaner is the hero of the story.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Because he's chasing his kid around with this vacuum cleaner. They don't explain shit. They don't explain why he's coming back, except that, you know, he's an angry spirit. Why? They don't explain how he took the cloak with him to the other world.
There's no explanation as to how he's able to be solid sometimes and not, or how his powers affect the actual world.
Mr. Boogedy has, he's a ghost, but he has allergies.
Mm-hmm. Now, to be fair, a lot of haunted house movies, you know, play around with that. Like, is it, you know, actually corporeal, or are they, you know, translucent shit? You know, they never stick to that, like, one thing or the other. So, I mean, that's a trope of horror films or haunted house movies that has bothered me for years.
Yes.
So I'm not going to place, you can place a lot of blame on this film. You guys are doing a great job. That's the one I'm like, all of them do that, though.
But as you say, that don't make it right.
No, I'm not. Very true, very true.
But boy, this is so stupid. That don't explain why, like you say, sometimes he's see-through, he's translucent, why sometimes you can, like, go through him, but his cloak can get caught up in the vacuum cleaner, which, when he's chasing his kid around, that's how he played himself.
Yeah. What have you done to me?
And that's Mr. Boogedy.
So now, I'm sorry, Chris, so which horror movie... It is the ghost defeated by a vacuum cleaner?
That's Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, he got you. Yeah, that's it.
Oh, yeah. See this?
Your ghost science is tight.
I know it is.
But Martin, I would give it this right here. You know, this is like if you had Ghostbusters in the proton pack, say, of the day, without the Ghostbusters.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, oh, why? Gosh, why are we even here?
Yeah, exactly.
Just show up and set down a proton pack and go back to the office.
Yeah. Luigi's Mansion.
Another good one. Yeah.
Yeah. True. So, yeah. But again, there was somebody attached to it. This family is fucking useless.
It is funny that the vacuum cleaner can suck in his cloak, but not him.
But not him. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. What's the rules there?
No logic.
So this fool, this family is useless. Luigi's got the vacuum cleaner on his back. The Ghostbusters got the proton pack. This vacuum cleaner said, fuck, nobody's going to do anything. I will.
And the thing is, Dad had rigged up the other vacuum cleaner to have a clown pop out of it.
Oh,
it's
shit.
A good thing they had one that actually worked.
Yeah, he should have did, because he just broke the other vacuum cleaner for a gag. That is it.
Yeah, yeah. Once that happened, I was like, because looking at it, I was like, man, I know this movie's only 45 minutes long, but it feels longer than that. And it's like, all right, we get into the first confrontation. How long to the second confrontation? It was like, no, that's it. We're done.
People, that's it, man. When that is it. Vacuum cleaner went in and sucked his cloak up. And Mr. Boogedy, with no explanation, like, well, shit, my powers. Well, I don't have anything else to do here. See ya.
Guess I'll just die.
There's nothing more to see here. Bye. In the family... didn't learn a goddamn thing. They didn't pack up and be like, oh, I guess we better get out of here before something else comes up. No,
ghosts are gone now.
No, the ghosts are gone.
That's true.
Now. Are they?
Besides, as we all know, there are no such things as ghosts.
Shit.
I'm over. Oh, now you're going to look shocked. After all this crazy shit, oh, now that's the one that got you. The winking paper jack-in-the-box man. That's it. Oh, did y'all see that? Oh, you stupid ass.
Well, it's messed with the one thing he cares about, his gags, his toys and shit. That's the only time. Yeah. My family.
Start hunting his gag.
Maybe I'll possess your gag.
No, it's not serious. No, it's personal.
Yeah, I'll speak to this fool through his own gags. Yeah, you stupid ass. And there you go, people. And that is the end of Mr. Boogedy right there.
Man, this movie was a colossal waste of time. And it's only 45 minutes. I was like, I cannot believe how... Like ABC, they have money. That's a real station. They should have been embarrassed about the corners they cut. You got, what, 8 people all together in this movie, and it's all shot from that house or that stage at the elementary school. And, the gags are tired. And so much of the, like, look, I know you had the whole thing with the goofy dad, but there had to be somebody going, please, enough already.
Yeah, just stop. Please stop.
Can we give him some personality?
Yeah, he got a joy buzzer.
Although all I can think watching this was like, man, it'd be so great to just update this. Somebody remake it, but just put in all the stuff we're talking about and acknowledge these things.
Yeah, like there's no ghost at all. The whole family's mentally ill. All of them seeing shit that's not there.
I mean, it'd be sort of like The Shining, where it seems like this magical stuff, but it's really about these people who have serious behavioral problems.
Yeah, yeah. Alcoholics, dad's like autistic or something. Keeps making these gags.
Is his inability to deal with life is just thrown into him laughing and doing these pranks.
Yeah,
because he got traumatized when he was young.
They keep telling kids there's some shit there, so they just start seeing shit. And somebody, near the end, we find out the Big Shyamalan twist of... A psychiatrist comes in, he's like, there's nothing here. These people are crazy.
Or there was a drifter in your house the whole time who was terrorizing your kids and
it's
raped your daughter.
It's a homeless family living in a shack. The whole time. A crazy homeless family. People been missing around town since they've been here. Well, brace yourself for Bride of Boogedy.
Oh, no, I saw when I looked this up. Just like, do you want this one or do you want the sequel? I was like, sequel.
Yeah, man.
Saving that for another time.
Yeah. Yeah, they ain't not dumb. You're not done with you yet, Martin. Boogedy is not finished with you. Funny, Martin just got a boogedy, boogedy, boogedy.
Where'd he go? That's the third film.
Oh, all right, folks. There you go.